So, we've come to the end of the journey. In this episode, we will, among others, visit the most famous landscape photography location in all of Scotland, if not the entire Great Britain.
This is just absolutely glorious. That was crazy, but so worth it.
The Old Man of Stawe is probably the most famous landscape photography location in all of Scotland, if not the entire Great Britain. It's unique, it's iconic, it's dramatic, it's rough, and it's the perfect focal point. Located on the eastern side of the Isle of Skye, on clear days it can be seen and photographed from miles away. The car park is easy to find along the road, and the trail up there is easy to follow, but it is a very demanding hike. Especially if you are in a run to reach the sunrise and don't have time to take a breathing pause. We had spent 1.5 hours in the car getting here, and the sunrise did look very promising. Arriving at the top, you have several vantage points, and being unfamiliar with the locations, I went for the most famous and obvious.
This place is amazing! Just look at those clouds! Nobody told me how hard the hike to Old Man of Stawe is. They all said it's 45 minutes of hike, but that was crazy, but so worth it. Look at this, look at those clouds! And up here, it's so beautiful. Obviously, nothing's ever perfect. Like, it would be really nice if we would have these cloud streaks pointing towards up here, Old Man of Stawe, but you can't get everything. But I'm pretty sure I shouldn't be sad about this. It's so beautiful.
It's an obvious sunrise location all year round from all points of view, and during winter it'll also work great for sunsets. But be aware, the huge ridge next to the rocks will cut off the last light of the sunset. It can also be very windy, so bring proper clothes which can breathe yet shield you from the wind.
The wind up here is crazy. I have to go a bit away, not to stand and yell in the face of the other photographers, but I'm having such a hard time getting a sharp shot. Shooting at 50 megapixels, even though the sun is up now and so forth, it's so shaky, even with a 3,000 crowns tripod, which is around $500. And shooting with brackets, 5 brackets, it's hard to get them even and just like on top of each other. I have to put everything down. I even attached my backpack to it, trying to keep it all down with some weight. But yeah, that's also a problem you will have to face. But the sunrise, or the really nice colors, is over now. So I think we'll just enjoy the rest of the time up here.
After finishing up at the traditional vantage point, we explored the area a bit further.
Alright, so we have enjoyed the sunrise. It was absolutely spectacular. So now we come down to a lower perspective, which I have to admit I actually prefer to the safe spot up there, but yeah, there wasn't time for experimenting too much. Anyway, so right now we have Sophie standing up here to show the size of it all. Then we have the path down here leading up towards the Old Man of Stawe, and down from this corner we have more lines leading up, and then we have like a strong central composition, as I preferred. On top of that, I have put on the polarizing filter. You can see the difference here without polarization and with. And with looks just so good. So that is basically the composition here. And in my opinion, it is stronger and also a bit more epic than the safe shot from up behind me.
The entire area is quite big, so using an ultra wide angle lens is not necessary to capture it all. I'd recommend a standard 24-70mm lens. The Old Man of Store is famous for a reason, and I'd suggest planning out exactly what kind of shot you want before going there. There's a lot of inspiration to get on both Instagram and 500 pixels. A bit further up the road, you will find the Kilt Rock and Meals Falls viewpoint. It's very easy to access since the car park is next to the road and the viewpoint is next to the car park. The area is known for the characteristic basalt rocks, which makes up the entire ridge. The location is also an obvious sunrise location all year round. I gotta admit, I wasn't too optimistic about photographing anything special here since I'm not fond of the view from the viewpoint at all. Problem being, you're standing on top of the ridge. It's a bit like entering the Eiffel Tower to take a photo of the Eiffel Tower. It just doesn't work. Don't get me wrong, it's an amazing location, but it does look better from either the seaside or air. To me, it was an obvious location for the drone. So here we are, the journey's end. This is the last location I'll present from me and Sophie's 18 days tour of the Great Britain. And I figured we might as well end with a bang. The Quarrying is by far one of the most epic locations in all of the Scottish Highlands. The area is formed by a massive landslip which has formed high cliffs, hidden plateaus and pinnacles of rock. Along the hiking trail there are countless possibilities for foreground overviewing the Trottinish Ridge. The trail is fairly easy to find following the road inland from Staffin, and this road is not made for supporting big cars, trucks and RVs. It's narrow and one-laned. Approaching from Staffin, you'll just have to drive up through a couple of sharp turns. When you're at the top, there's a small car park. My advice is to go here out of season, since it's a very popular location. The trail is actually a round trip, but for photographers it's the first part which is the most interesting. The trail itself is a fairly moderate hike, which most people should be able to enjoy. As I've already mentioned, there are plenty of opportunities for different foregrounds. At the beginning of the trail you'll find trees along the edge. Further in you'll find small plateaus upon which you can place people overlooking the ridge. At the top of the trail you can divert from the main path and climb even further up between some pointy and sharp cliffs. This area is super fascinating and you might recognize it as the location where we filmed the intro for this series. As always, the weather will greatly influence what kind of photos you will get, and on this specific location we sadly didn't really get anything extraordinary weather-wise. The dramatic landscape is very well complemented by dramatic weather, so aim for a day with showers and sunbeams. It is also a great sunrise location, but we prioritized the Old Man of Store for the only sunrise we had while in the Isle of Skye. I'd recommend focal length of 16 to 200 mm here, since there are a great variety of compositions.
So Isle of Skye has been absolutely amazing. It is a little bit touristy, but, well, it's actually very touristy, but it is so worth coming here and photograph. I have got some of my very best and most spectacular pictures on the Isle of Skye. And so with that, here is the last picture.
The landscapes of England, Wales and Scotland are something to treasure and something to be proud of. This journey has fully lived up to my expectations. It is not the last time I've been to Great Britain for landscape photography, that's for sure. I'm extremely proud of the series I've put together, and it is by far my biggest and most intense project ever when it comes to making a finished and well-rounded product. My series from Britain has been a huge success. My watch time and subscriber base has increased a lot the past couple of months, and I'm very, very happy for all the sweet and supporting comments. I also hope you'll keep following the adventure outside of Britain, because the adventure didn't stop after Sophie and I were done on this great island. After we finished the Isle of Skye, we spent a couple of days driving down through Europe to hook up with three other amazing photographers in Munich for a week in the Alps. This will be the continuation of my Europe series, since we are visiting some of the most iconic and epic photography locations in both Germany, Italy and Austria, and I promise you will see both excitement and disappointment. As this is the last episode from Great Britain, I'd love to get some recommendations on locations or areas in Great Britain which I should visit in the future. I'm eager to hear some suggestions. So thank you again ever so much for watching. As always, I'd highly appreciate a like and a comment, and then I'll just wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.